1964, North Vietnamese torpedo boats attacked two U.S. warships in the Gulf of Tonkin. To retaliate to this, President Johnson ordered bombings of North Vietnam. Bombings continued well into 1965, and the public started to question the American government and why it had its role in attacking North Vietnam. Following the bombing of Vietnam, widespread discontent happened. Most of this started at college universities. Students for Democratic Society, called the SDS, started in 1960, but was only a small, unheard voice. But they were finally heard when the U.S. started bombing North Vietnam in 1965. They held teach-ins to educate students across the country campuses about why the U.S. involvement in Vietnam is wrong. Soon organized marches and protests were being held across the country. On April 17, 1965, 15,000 to 25,000 people marched on Washington. Hundreds of people are arrested. This led to a heavy increase in popularity among the SDS and similar groups. The SDS's popularity peaked in the Tet Offensive in 1968. Without victory in sight in Vietnam, most Americans became upset. In all, there are many groups of people with their own reason for opposing the war, but they are united by the fact that they're all against the Vietnam War. Some groups went off the immorality and atrocity of war. Lots of citizens just learned that the soldiers were fighting for a causeless war, and they want it all to come to an end. Vietnam Veterans Against the War was an organization of veterans who threw away their medals that they won during combat, and this swayed much public to their cause and caused lots and lots of people become anti-Vietnam. Before 1967, many Americans quietly supported the war, but now, after 1968 and during 1968, most people were against it. The draft was issued by President Johnson and President Nixon to recruit more troops to help relieve pressure in Vietnam on the soldiers that have already been stationed there. And people escaped to Sweden or Canada to avoid the conscription. And some draft cards that were given out were burned in mass groups. Soon, protests grew more frequent. The biggest one on October 21st, 1967, the biggest anti-war demonstration took place, where 100,000 protesters gathered at the Lincoln Memorial in Washington, D.C., and later that night, 30,000 of them continued in a march to the Pentagon. These protesters were stopped by the U.S. Marshals, hundreds were arrested, and a famous photo was taken when a protester was putting flowers in soldiers' guns. Another famous incident was the Kent State shooting in 1970. Nixon had announced that there was an invasion of Cambodia to help stop the spread of communism in Southeast Asia. In anger, students flooded the streets and torched the ROTC building at Kent State University in Ohio. 900 Ohio National Guardsmen were called in to stifle the riots. 28 guardsmen shot and killed 4 protesters and wounded 16 more. By February 1968, only 35% approved how Johnson was handling Vietnam. A full 50% disapproved. In October 1969, 2 million people partook in the Vietnam moratoriums that took place across the U.S. In April 1971, a massive march on Washington, D.C. occurred, and 12,000 people were arrested. Nixon finally declared that he was pulling back the troops and bringing them home. With this came the decline of all the protests and riots, and they became less and less frequent as their boys started coming back home. Never before has America been so opposed to a war. Soldiers came back and felt unappreciated, disrespectful for just serving our country. They are spat upon and hated. The massive amounts of opposition heavily affected how LBJ Nixon handled the war and their politics. The beginning of the hippies was because of the disillusionment of middle-class youth who traded in their lives for a life of psychedelic enjoyments, freedom, and experiencing new pleasures and feelings. Some opposed the Vietnam War, and some were actually leaders of anti-Vietnam movements, but for the most part, they wanted to break away from the conflict and normal social life and become non-political. Some moved out to the countryside and lived in teepees. Their new culture brought new things to the American public. Most of it was countercultural to what was the norm. They wore Native American style jackets with frills, sandals, headbands, long hair, colorful clothing, jewelry, and they used drugs a lot, and it became quite casual. They used marijuana, LSD, and other hallucinogens. They enjoyed being in a state of being high or stoned to enhance their love, peace, and tranquility feelings. The hippies listened to new music from Britain and America. British bands included Pink Floyd, The Beatles, Rolling Stones, and the Bonzo Dog Doodah Band. American bands they listened to were The Fugs and Jimi Hendrix. All of these were psychedelic rock. Hippies started the sexual revolution, which normalized premarital sex, support and use of contraceptives, and more freedom to do what you want. The hippies had several events with large gatherings of many, many, many people. In 1967, about 75,000 people gathered at the Haight-Ashbury corner in San Francisco. A personal account says, "It was the happiest place I'd ever seen. There's acid, weed, and free food." This is basically the biggest movement of the hippies where all the countercultures collided. Another famous event was Woodstock in Bethel, New York, where basically a bunch of concerts happened and lots of bands came and played. At Woodstock, there were a couple deaths related to being in that psychedelic state, and actually a couple babies were born during then. Pretty exciting stuff. The hippie influence left a long-lasting impression on America. This movement had normalized what many viewed as immoral or untraditional. In the following generations, some of the hippie norms were passed on and were integrated into American culture. In conclusion, in relation to today, many people now are opposed to conflict and instead support peace. Hippies were groundbreakers for smoking pot and doing other drugs such as LSD and other hallucinogens. They also led to lots and lots of new norms today.